guys, welcome to the video. Myself and Philip Warner here yet again, and this is Rate the Transfer Rumour. Now, Philip, I'm going to fling a few names at you. You don't know who they are and what clubs are linked with, and you're going to give them a rating between 1 and 10. So 1 being highly unlikely, obviously, and 10 being highly likely. So this might be a bit of fun. I'll start off with your own club, actually, and 1 involving my club as well. Lee Desmond to Shamrock Rovers. Now, I'm going to give you a narrative first here, right? Lee Desmond had a very good season at St. Patrick's Athletic. Centre-back can play in a back two, a back three, can play defence in midfield and left back. Now, Shamrock Rovers obviously have Joey O'Brien, Liam Scales, Pico Lopez, and who else am I missing? Lee Grace as their centre-backs. So on the outside looking in, it looks like they don't need him. However, his versatility could be a big thing as well. What would you give this?
Well, to be honest, I'd say probably a 5. Just off the bat from hearing it there, just because of the fact that we have got, I think we have enough centre-halves at the minute at the club. I'm not sure if he, can he play any left-back or right-back? Is he able to do that?
He's played left-back, yeah, and he can play defensive midfield as well. He's done that this season. He's played 4 different positions this season. He's played centre-back in a 2, centre-back in a 3 as well. So,
It is when you think about it, because if like a centre half wouldn't be the fourth thing that jumps at you when you think of where Shamrock Rovers need to strengthen. I'd go more fullbacks that we probably need to get a bit more depth into the squad. But as you said, he's had a good season, so like I haven't watched much of Pats, but I'd welcome anyone that's had a good coming off the back of a good season, regardless of who they're playing for. So.
No, he was definitely good at Pats this season, one of their best players, to be honest with you. But I suppose to throw in devil's advocate a little bit as well, if it's going to be a long season, which we hope it will be a long season, then Rovers might think, okay, Desmond can play left back, he can play centre back as a 2, as a 3, he can play defensive midfield. We're going to need bodies in there, like, you know, throughout the season. That might be their thought process if this rumour is something they're actually looking at, to be honest.
Yeah, and look, as you said, the long season it will be completely different next year. Talking about the squad depth, I think it's going to be massively important next season. You know, especially with COVID, it's probably going to still be here by the time the season starts. Like, do you know what I mean? And people probably will have to self isolate, and games will probably still go ahead, unless there's a mass breakout in camp. But yeah, no, I'd say squad depth is going to be very important, regardless of who it is, whether it be Shamrock Rovers or Finn Harps. Like, you know, so.
So you're going 5 out of 10.
Yeah, 5 out of 10. I haven't seen that in Stonewall about it, so I wouldn't say it's dead likely yet. Like, you know, so.
The next one I'm going to go with is Ryan Brennan from Shelburne to Drogheda. Now, Shelburne are obviously relegated, Drogheda were promoted. Ryan Brennan has been linked a good few times, actually, in certain quarters this season to Drogheda. He's a Drogheda man as well, which is notable. The Brennan family actually are synonymous, obviously, with Drogheda, with Sean and Killian and people like that. How do you see this rumour?
I would say about a 7, maybe an 8, just simply off the fact that, like, it's his hometown club, do you know what I mean? And one's gone down, the other's gone up, so... Like, at the end of the day, it will be probably something, one of the more likely ones that we chat about, just off the fact that it's home-based, they're going up, and Shells are going down, and they look a bit of a mess, to be honest, and I wouldn't like to be anywhere near that camp at the moment, simply off the fact of how poorly they have been.
It's a troublesome camp. The next one I'll get on to is Michael Duffy to Derry City. Now, this will be an interesting one. I mean, Duffy, he proved the other day, didn't he? He's still got a lot of quality. He is out of contract at this minute in time. Derry City, he's a Derry man as well. So that it all fits the narrative, doesn't it? But do you see this one happening?
No, it's a 4. I don't know why. I have a feeling, I don't know if you remember with Hoobin. Remember there was a bit of malarkey with Hoobin there a couple of seasons back about his contract and stuff, and then eventually he signed. I think it's gonna play out like that. I think he is gonna re-sign for Dundalk, and I think Dundalk are gonna come back better than what they have been this season, to be honest with you. I know they've got Europe and on that kind of took the eyes off the fact of their poor league form. But it is a logical transfer if it does happen, but at the same time, I think they're going to strengthen Dundalk, to be honest with you, with the money they've got from Europe. So, no, I don't see that happening. It's more unlikely than likely.
So, do you think the possibility that Duffy, not necessarily Duffy, but you could be toying with the idea of a Derry to try and get a bit better deal at Dundalk. It's something that you might see, or just a deal to make sure they keep him or whatever.
Exactly, yeah, and I'm pretty sure Holman done the same thing as well, because he wanted a couple of years on the contract, didn't he? And the fact was, Rovers were sniffing about, like, do you know what I mean? Which obviously kind of played into his hands. I don't know about, I don't think Duffy will play it out in that sense, if his contract sorted out and just be able to focus on his football. That's the type of footballer I think he is. So, I'd say he'll probably re-sign, but at the same time, wouldn't be surprised if it did go through.
What are you going again? Out of 10?
Four out of 10.
The next one we'll go with is Daniel Kelly from Dundalk to Bohemians. Now, clearly Bohemians are looking for a player on that side of the pitch since they lost Chris Twardek. He was at Bohemians before. Out of all the wingers, he's probably played the least for Dundalk this season, to be honest. Quality player, though. How do you see this one?
You know something? It would be a logical transfer, but it doesn't seem to me like he's a Keith Long signing. I know that sounds very cliche, but anyone that Keith's brought in has kind of been someone that probably hasn't been as known as the likes of himself and has went on to improve significantly. I just can't see that sort of development there with him, just simply off the fact that he hasn't played so much for Dundalk. Are they questioning his ability? Like, you know, I don't know if has he been hit with injury or anything like that? Like, because I haven't seen much of him. Yeah, no, exactly. He has been available, as you said there, for most of the season. It could be. I'd say I would give it probably about a seven, or six rather, sorry, six. Just simply off the fact he's not playing. But again, the reason why I haven't gone stronger on this one is because I don't think he's a Keith Long signing.
That's an interesting one. Darren Markey from St. Patrick's Lake to Sligo Rovers now. Obviously, Liam Buckley is a Sligo Rover, so everything seems to fit with a lot of rumours, don't they? You know, managed Darren Markey before. Darren Markey's well down the pecking order of St. Patrick's Athletic and hasn't even appeared on the bench, by the way, for the last three or four games. And there's no real concrete info on him being injured or anything. So it probably points he's leaving. But the question is he going to Sligo in your view?
Yeah, I'd say A on this one, because at the end of the day, it seemed like Buckley liked him when he was at Pats. Like, so, and to be honest with you, I've seen him once or twice for Pats. He's not a bad footballer either, like, you know. So that would probably be one of the more stronger ones that we're going to chat about in terms of actually going through. It would be nice to see him back playing, because from the couple of times that I've seen him, he has got potential there to be a good footballer. I'd say that probably will go through. Whether he goes to Sligo or not, that's why I haven't gone eight. That's why I haven't got 10. But I'd say 8 off the fact that he could go somewhere else.
Final one then we'll go with Jason Cabilla from Shelburne to Cork City. Now, Cabilla fell out of favour with Ian Morris, and publicly, actually, didn't he mention Ian Morris mentioned something about contract issues or something like that? He did come on in the last game, actually, but that might have been desperation stuff, because Shelburne were in serious trouble, 1-0 down, then to 10 men. You know, we have to try something. I believe he's from Cork as well. Obviously, Cork are in the first division also. How do you see this one going?
I would say 7, just off the fact that there's no up or down in division, regardless of the two sides, because they're both in the same division, obviously, this year. Just simply because of, again, it's like Brennan, where it's a hometown club. Like, you know, obviously he wasn't playing last season, so I could just imagine. I didn't see any of them, to be honest with you. But in terms of that one, I would say that it's going to happen simply off the fact that they're not happy. Both camps aren't happy at Shells with what's going on. If a player wants away, usually they do get away.
And as you say, if he wants to go back to Cork, but we don't know if that's for sure or not. He was in and out with the Shelburne team this season as well. And, you know, after having a good season in the First Division, he did struggle with the Premier Division, in my opinion, physically. But, you know, if Morris is staying at Shelburne now, I'd say it's highly unlikely Cabilla is going to stay at Shelburne. And it seems maybe, out of the ones, I would say this is the more likely, in my opinion, that Cabilla goes to Cork City, I think.
Yeah, you know. It's not off the cards. I was surprised with Luke Bourne actually re-signing for Shells. Very surprised at that. We all know how good he is, but I was just surprised that his discipline record was horrible, as we spoke about before. And he's not getting any. He's not like that. He's old, but he's not getting any younger, like, in terms of his age. So, Surprised at that one. But no, as you said, it's whether or not he wants to go back to Cork. Maybe, I don't think it won't happen, but maybe another club from Dublin might get in there. But he just hasn't done enough. In my sense, he hasn't done enough to warrant the move to any other big club. So Cork would seem reasonable, to be fair.
Brilliant, guys. Like, subscribe, and let us know what you think in the comments, the likeliness or unlikeliness of some of these transfers. Thanks for watching. Thanks again, Philip.